If you are thinking of going on an Antarctica expedition cruise, then you may be wondering what you should wear when you leave the ship for excursions. Stay tuned to this video and find out. It's coming up. Hi fellow travelers, this is Ken and welcome to my channel, Ken Travels 360. If you have finally decided to book an Antarctica expedition cruise, then you may be wondering what you need to wear when you make landings or go on zodiac cruises from your ship. If you check the average temperatures chart for the Antarctic Peninsula during the summer months, you will find temperatures hovering around 0 degrees Celsius or 32 degrees Fahrenheit. This will be similar temperature to the Northern Hemisphere winter, but the clothes you wear will be very different. The reality is that the weather in Antarctica can be extremely variable. If the sun is shining and there is no wind and you may be walking uphill, you could find yourself suddenly getting very warm and drenched in sweat very quickly. On the other hand, you could be zodiac cruising and you will feel a lot cooler due to the lack of body movement. And then suddenly the winds pick up and before you know, the temperatures suddenly feel polar. So the key is to dress in multiple removable layers so that you can adjust. For me, the first layer is to have a synthetic t-shirt and followed by synthetic leggings. Synthetic materials are useful because unlike cotton, they don't absorb all the sweat. Next, I put on a merino woolen jumper. It weighs very little and it is very comfortable and it keeps me really warm. Right, after that, you can put on as many layers as you like, but probably not too many to be too bulky. For me, I decided to put on a fleece, which is quite light, but it adds another layer, so it'll keep me warmer. Then, very importantly, I have a pair of waterproof trousers. This is mandatory. You must have that, and it has to have a wide bottom here that will cover the boots that your cruise company will either provide you with or allow you to rent. There are some cruise company where you actually have to bring your own, but in any case, these trousers have to go over them. In addition, there are a few items that you will definitely need as well. The first one is a hat. The hat has to cover your ears because it's going to be very cold and you need to protect your ears as well. Next, they recommend a net gaiter. So be careful, you can't just wear a scarf because it's very windy out there and they say you need to bring a net gaiter. Obviously, you also need gloves, but actually you need more than one pair of gloves. First, they recommend you to have a thin pair of liner gloves. You put them on and then you put on a pair of waterproof gloves or ski gloves. This is very important because splashing from the zodiac through icy water will otherwise get your gloves wet. For socks, they recommend you to get a pair of wool socks. I have got a pair of merino wool socks. They are thermal socks that will keep myself really warm. But they also recommend you wear two pairs of socks. That will keep you even warmer. So the second pair can be any socks, just go over this one. So with two pairs of socks, that means when you try to get your boots, you have to get a pair that might have to be larger than normal. So make sure you wear both pair of socks when you try out your boots. Finally, you will have to wear the parka provided by the cruise company to you. Everyone will be issued one, and most likely you get to keep this after the cruise as well. They're usually very nice, colorful looking. They are very, very bright color because they want to spot you easily when you land in the snow. Right, we're ready for our first expedition and this is how you end up dressed like. Yes, you've grown twice in size.